of all, why educational audios? Why should we have educational audios in any case on our community radio station? So as Dr. Sridhar has very rightly said, that the first concern is social concern. First of all, because you have a commitment to the society that education, health, all these areas are very crucial areas, and we should have educational programs for your societal commitment. The other thing is whether you call your mandate or legal concerns. As he has said, that 50% of the program you have to give for your communities, but the rest of the 50%, what you should do with that time period. And definitely education becomes a very important element in that. Not only that, any community, you are making programs for community with their participation, of course, but any community, you can't have a community which have no concerns with education. So definitely it is also one of their concerns. So it is also one of the concerns of the first 50% and also the rest of the 50%. Secondly, those which are campus radios, they also have a community in form of students. That is also a community there. So in that case, their educational requirement is much, much more. So with any standards you go, definitely you should have some educational programs on your radio stations. Then how to have it? How you should have it? See, either you can adopt, obtain, or acquire. All the three things have been discussed in the morning. That there are institutions which are ready to give you programs. They have the software, they have the capabilities, they are ready to share their software and you use them. So one thing is that either you acquire on whatever financial or non-financial concerns and you adopt them, or they are given to you, so you broadcast. That is one thing. Another thing is adaptation. You will have to, some of the programs you will have to adapt according to your own condition, because community radio is basically to taking care of your local concerns. So some of the programs maybe you will have to adapt. And the third thing is that you produce. You produce programs for NIOS, and I'll come to that, how you can, it has been discussed also, but I'll come to that, that what do I mean by that. Well, if I don't tell anything about Gyanvani, it is not proper, because in the presence of a person who had initiated Gyanvani, Dr. Sridhar, and he was instrumental in making it a reality, that now there is a full-fledged FM educational radio channel, 37 stations are operational, and they are there. I'm telling it is live, but it is not kicking. I know that there are several problems in the implementation, organization. It is not doing well, we all know. Even at ICRU, we know that there are some serious problems. But that is, keeping all these things apart, there is an educational FM radio channel which is catering to educational programs, and they also have a mandate to broadcast these type of programs where they can collaborate with community radios or other organizations like NIO. When we call of partnerships, we are talking about a partnership. This is a brainstorming session. You are representing community radio sector, and we are all from educational organizations, big organizations, national organizations like NIOS or IGNU or big university, Guwahati University. So, see, the crux of any partnership is that both the partners should get something out of it. It is not a If sometimes the partnerships are that one partner becomes of like a big brotherly treatment, then it doesn't work. It doesn't go very long. And secondly, it has to be viable in the sense that both of them should get something out of it. Sometimes we say, we are giving to you this thing and we are partners. We are not. Then you are givers, we are receivers, you are donors, we are takers, we are not partners. Partners mean both of us are contributing something for the betterment. It's a win-win situation. Both of them are benefiting from this thing. So we have to be actual partners if we think this collaboration. And as it was said in the morning, that whenever we call PPP, of course, it is also the need of the hour that we have PPP, like public-private partnerships. But sometimes it also raises question marks, because public-private partnerships, as Dr. Sridhar said, that many people get worried about that. But in my opinion, I take it further. Nowadays, there is no PPP, no public and private partner, whom you are calling public. It is basically government. Government is not public. So I will extend it further and I will call it GCPP, Government, Community, Private Partnership.
Number, and if anybody will ring to that number, then automated voice will come, and whatever the caller will say will be recorded, automatically recorded. So we used it for to make the area zero dropout. We are announcing that if you have any girl or boy in your village are not going to school, they drop out, then just intimate us. Togetherly, we will send that child to the school. Then what happened? People ring us and tell us that Mr. X or Minir, Rimar, Babu is out of school in our village, so and so. Then immediately we broadcast it in the radio and we request, we have database of the intellectuals, PRI members, teachers, etc. Different GPs and villages, so that immediately with name we are requesting in our special radio program, Chala School, Kujivadar. Dr. Sridhar is there in your village, Sita is out of school. Now please let us come together and we will send Sita to the school. And our team were reaching in that village, a particular village, and we are sending that child to the school. Again, we are giving thanks who they supported us in that particular village. And after all, within 1 or 2 months, it created a campaign and automatically people were informing us. And they were sending the child and intimating us that child is now in the school. With this process, we have adopted only 15 villages, but in impact of such program, we got 165 village zero dropout. And government of Odisha has declared 165 school zero dropout. So right now, I'm thinking we can match such program.
Which area of Odisha?